Welcome to High School Basketball here on KBZE 105.9 FM and internet radio station KBZE.com. Tonight, the Central Catholic Eagles are taking on the Calvary Baptist Cavaliers in the LHSAA Basketball Quarterfinals. Tonight's game is being brought to you by A.J. Doman Chevrolet, A.J. Doman Chrysler, Tesh Action Clinic of Morgan City, Thibodeau Regional, G.J. Curbside, Taco Bell, Morgan City Mayor Lee Dragna, Morgan City Councilman Lou Tamparello, State Senator Brett Allen, St. Mary Parish President David Hanegrip, St. Mary Parish Sheriff Blaze Smith, St. Mary Parish Assessor Jared Longman, Vita Paint and Supply, Halimer Shipyards, Conrad Shipyards, and Charlie's Pawn Shop and Best Jewelers. Now, here's KBZE Sports Director Seth Thomas with a call of tonight's game.
Thank you, Captain. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to KBZ, our coverage of Central Catholic High School basketball tonight. We're in Shreveport, Louisiana, on the campus of Calvary Baptist High School. And tonight it's a quarterfinal matchup in Division IV between Central Catholic and Calvary Baptist. Central Catholic comes in as the sixth seed out of District 8. They were 18-4 on the season, undefeated in district. They have won 12 out of the last 14. Last year they lost in round 1 to Riverside. Meanwhile, Calvary Baptist, number 3 out of District 1. They were 23-5, 7-0 in district. They've won 11 straight. Last year, they were defeated in the state championship game by Crescent City, 60-49. Both of these teams have beat the teams they should beat. All their losses have come to big teams. Calvary Baptist, their 5 losses came to number 5, Bossier in 3A, number 1, U High from Division 2, number 1, Rayville from 2A, number 5, Huntington from 4A, and Jehovah Jireh, who is number 1 in Division 5. Meanwhile, Central Catholic, they lost to St. Martinville, number 11 in 3A. Thibodeau, who upset number 2, West Monroe, in the first round of the 5A playoffs, number 24 in 4A, Assumption, and number 6 in 4A, Ellender. Look at the bracket. One team has already advanced to the state semifinals. That's number 5, Metairie Park Country Day. They beat St. Ed's 92-53. Tonight, number 1, Crescent City hosts number 8, Hamilton Christian. And then on the bottom of the bracket, number 2, Riverside Academy battles number 7, Opelousas Catholic. All roads lead to the Barton Coliseum and next week's state championship semifinals and finals. Right now, we're going to go back to our studio. We're going to take our first pregame break. When we get to come back, we'll have the starting lineups and more. Central Catholic and Calvary Baptist right here on KBZE.
Located inside Charlie's Pawn Shop in Morgan City is Best Jewelers. They have fine jewelry like diamond tennis bracelets, diamond stud earrings, watches, and many other items. The deals are absolutely incredible. And oh, while you're browsing, let Harold Syracuse check and clean your jewelry. And bring your scrap gold because they pay top dollar. Yes, you'll discover that Charlie's Pawn Shop and Best Jewelers complement each other. Think about it. Best is with fine jewelry, and Charlie's with everything imaginable, like guns, guitars, amplifiers, tools, electronics, and the list goes on and on. So what are you waiting for? Are you kidding me? Put your mind at ease. One visit, and you'll be hooked. This is truly a delightful shopping experience. It's amazing. You get it all. Friendly, personal service, and quality at unbelievable prices from people who care about you. All under one roof. It's Best Jewelers and Charlie's Pawn Shop, Highway 182 East, across from Vita Paint.
At Thibodeau Regional Wellness Center, we're improving the health and well-being of the region, one person at a time. And this means more game time, more first times, more crunch time, more face time, and more party time. Isn't it time you started living your best life? Change starts here at Thibodeau Regional Wellness Center.
Now with Taco Bell's app, you can build a box filled with your favorites. Personally, I go with the chalupa.
What? You mean Crunchwrap Supreme, plus that beefy five-layer burrito.
Perhaps you meant bean burrito, grilled with chips and nacho cheese sauce.
Nah, you got a vibe with cinnamon twists and a Baja Blast.
Eat like you with Taco Bell's Build Your Own Cravings box, exclusively online or with the Taco Bell app. Must make selections from predetermined menu items and limited participating U.S. locations for a limited time online or in the Taco Bell app only. Contact store for participation, which varies. Drinks exclude freezes.
I don't know about you, but I cannot escape my cravings for Taco Bell's nacho fries. It doesn't matter where I am or what I'm doing or what time of day it is. I see the warm nacho cheese sauce everywhere. I can smell the Mexican spices. Sometimes my cravings even haunt me in my sleep. Luckily, I found out the one way to escape the cravings. Run to Taco Bell, because nacho fries are back. That's right, you're safe, but only for a limited time. So hurry to a participating Taco Bell location near you for the nacho fries box and get your cravings under control. Or they'll control you. DoorDash delivery available.
It's time for you to save like never before at A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Are you ready for a great deal? A money-saving party! We got new and used cars, trucks, and vans. We'll get you kick-started. Yeah, our service, our selection are out of sight. Come deal with us, we're gonna treat you right.
A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep. On the corner of Highway 90 and 182 at the foot of the bridge in Berwick.
Okay, so you've fallen in love with a new sofa or found great fabric for your windows? How do you take the guesswork out of selecting wall colors? PPG Pittsburgh Paints makes it easy. The voice of color in stores. Color tubes help you select the perfect color palette for your home. Unique 5 color chips do all the coordination for you, from paint and flooring to fabrics and window treatments, so you can choose colors with confidence effortlessly. Vital Paint and Supply, 3 locations, Morgan City, Homa, and Lafayette.
We're back here at Calvary Baptist. We're about, about 5-6 minutes away from the start of this one. How these two teams got here. Calvary Baptist in round one beat St. Frederick's by a score of 72-33. Meanwhile, Central Catholic beat Sacred Heart of Villeplatte 61-49. Also, tonight, or right now, going on, Franklin, they started at 4:30 over in Doyle. That's a 5-4 matchup in two-way to see who goes to the state semifinals. The last score I got, Doyle was on top of Franklin, 50-47. I'm not sure if that was in the fourth quarter yet or still late in the third, but coming down to cases over in Doyle for the Franklin Hornets. The one difference you do see in these two teams, of course, a height differential really goes to Calvary Baptist. They have a 6'7", a 6'6", and a 6'4 player. Meanwhile, DJ Lewis, about 6'5". He's the biggest that Central Catholic has. And, of course, Central Catholic, no seniors. Everybody underclassmen. Meanwhile, Calvary Baptist, 5 seniors. Again, they were in the state championship game last year. Thought they had a chance to win it this year. They think they have another one. They won state in football. They're one of those programs who dropped down from 2A, and now they'll have one more year after this one in Division IV before bouncing back up to Division III. But an unbelievable gym. 12 goals in this gym that come down and go up, 12 of them. And they have a walking track around the top. They have 102 chairback seats across the way on the home side, plus bleacher seating on each side. The visitor side, 5 rows. I imagine they probably have 200 seats for the visitors. And behind each goal, if you look to the right, they have another, 300 seats. So I guess this place could probably hold about, 800. And it is a huge high school gym, a nice wooden floor, a lot of room behind each bench to the stands. So, I mean, just an unbelievable campus. The football field, had a chance to ride around a little bit and look. First-class facility here in Shreveport for Calvary Baptist. Coach Bree Case and Coach Ron Case leading the Eagles tonight. This is the roster first for the Eagles. Number one is Tyler Smith. Number two is Nylon Williams. Number three, Vernon Singleton. Number four is Dominic Case. Number five is DJ Lewis. Number 10 is Tylen Hollins. 21 is Gary Nycar. 13 is R.J. Bennett. Number 11 is Demondrick Blackburn. 23 is Kai Morgell. 24 is Ben Case, and number 50 is Angelo Viscardi. Meanwhile, looking at Calvary Baptist, number 2 is Daniel Ortiz. Number 3, Rondé Hill. Number 4 is Johnny Cox. Number 5, Martin McDowell. Number 10 is Ben Ponder. Number 11 is Chase Striplin. Number 12 is Sinceri Richards. Number 15 is Will Begley. 22 is Grant Fontana. Number 23 is LeBrez Williams, and number 24 is Trey Kelly. Key to the game for the Eagles is going to be, first of all, not get intimidated by the place. The North has not been kind to the Eagles in the playoffs. It seems like the last four or five trips up North, the Eagles hadn't played real well. Coach Case would like to see that change tonight. He also knows Eagles are really have to play one of their top games of the season. It's a very seasoned, good ball club on the other side. I think foul trouble will be big for the Eagles and handling the press. You know, Calvary may come out with some pressure defense, so the Eagles are going to have to stop that. I think we're going to have the national anthem in a second, so we're going to not go to the break yet. We'll let you know when we go to that break, so that way we are not interfering with the lineups and the anthem. So right now we will go back to the studio, take our final break. We'll come back with a tip-off. Central Catholic and Calvary Baptist right here on KBZE.
Harley Holland here with A.J. Doman, Chevrolet Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana. Good credit, bad credit, no credit. Hey, we can help you. We understand. We've lived through this COVID along with you. With your good job and your down payment, we can get you riding in a new vehicle today. Come down and see us at A.J. Doman Chevrolet Cadillac, and let us show you how easy we can make it for you. A.J. Doman Chevrolet Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana.
Your life just got way easier with G.J. Curbside. G&J, owned and operated by three generations of the Lynn family since 1964, has created a new division to serve the community's retail needs in St. Mary Parish with a curbside grocery and delivery service. Choose from fresh produce, high-end meats, dairy, canned goods, cleaning supplies, and the list grows daily. Visit GJCurbside.com. That's GJCurbside.com.
And right now we have the singing of the national anthem. Singing of the national anthem. We'll have the starting lineups announced, and then we will have the tip-off. We were just told that the Franklin Hornets defeated Doyle by 5. The Hornets are in the semifinals in Lake Charles next week. KBZ will be with them, so keep it locked in to find out what exact day that is. But the Hornets, who were down, came back and won it. Here is your starting lineup. DJ Lewis, number 5. Tyler Smith, number 1. Demondre Blackburn, number 11. Gary Nykar, number 21. And Kai Morgale, number 23. And here is your starters for the Cavaliers. Announced for Calvary Baptist. As they'll come out, number 15, that is Will Begley. Number 5 is Martin McDowell. Number 23, that is LeBrez Williams. Number 10 is Ben Ponder. And the final starter, waiting for him to take off his warm-up top. And that is number two, that is Daniel Ortiz. As we mentioned, Franklin, on to the semifinals. The fifth-ranked Hornets advance with a win over Doyle. They'll play in Burton Coliseum next week. And keep it locked into KBZ. We'll have it for you. It'll be Williams jumping against Lewis, and we're set to go. Glad you'll be with us tonight for high school playoff basketball on the breeze. And this tip is controlled by Calvary Baptist. Here is Ortiz. Eagles starting a 2-3 zone. Ortiz out top. Over to Begley. And that ball knocked out of bounds by Morgell. Calvary has it. Ortiz, the point guard. Out top to McDowell. He'll dribble left side in the corner. That ball almost stolen by Blackburn. He goes into the Central Catholic bench. And the ball stays with Calvary Baptist. McDowell out top. Over to Begley. In the corner, Williams, who drives, goes up. And they say he's fouled going to the basket. He'll shoot two and let's see who the foul is on. And that is on DJ Lewis. And that's going to be just huge. And you know Calvary Baptist is going to take it right at Lewis, try to get him in foul trouble. He is the only guy that can match up height-wise with Calvary Baptist. First free throw is no good. One more upcoming, no score yet in the game. That free throw is in, and it's 1-0. Calvary Baptist, here is the pressure. Man-to-man, full court. Here's Blackburn. Up ahead to Smith. Double team, gets it over to Blackburn. He'll drive, kicks it to Lewis on the ball. He turns around, blocked away by Williams. Williams gets the block. He'll take it up himself. He'll drive on Williams. Lewis, he goes to the basket, reverse layup. No good, Nycard pulls it down. Blackburn trying to get it up ahead to Smith. Blackburn gets it back and then stolen by Ponder. Here's Williams down the lane. Kicked it off with a charge on Williams. Great defense by Jerry Nycar. Williams was looking to pass it. Nycar steps in front. Gets a charge on the big man. Good defense by Nycar. And the ball will go back to Central Catholic. 6:50 to go here in the first quarter. 1-0. Calvary Baptist. Here comes Lewis into the front court off to Smith. Tyler goes down, and they say he travels with it. Slipped down on the floor. Coach Case is saying, calm down. He tried to get a little too quick. Calvary Baptist fall. And now it will be McDowell working the point. Over to Ortiz, right side in the corner. Williams. Back out to McDowell. Over to Ortiz. He'll drive down the lane. Kicks it off. There's a shot up. No good by Ponder. Rebound controlled by the Cavaliers. Three ball on the way. No good. Ponder got it back up and in. Good offensive rebound by Ponder. He puts it back. 3-0 Cavaliers. We have some phone difficulties. The calls dropped. It was a foul by Ortiz. Blackburn had two free throws. He missed them both. Still 3-0 Calvary Baptist. Here's Williams on the outside. McDowell will line up the three-pointer. No good. Rebound by Begley. The Ponder. Here's Williams down the lane. He goes up in and he fouls. Williams down the lane. And there's Lewis' second foul. Williams just big and strong. He's about 2 inches taller than DJ and probably got him by about 15 pounds. Gets the basket, and he'll shoot two. He makes the second one, so it's 6-0, Calvary Baptist. Full court man-to-man by the Cavaliers. Here's Blackburn into the front court. Looking for a screen. Goes by Ortiz. Kicks it to Morgell in the corner. Down inside to Lewis. Back out to Smith. Lewis had his shot blocked, and he's kind of backing away from Williams. Smith goes up. No good. Lewis got the rebound. Up. No good. Rebound goes to Ponder. McDowell way up ahead. It goes to Begley down the lane. His layup is in. They beat the Eagles down the floor. And the layup is in. And it's 8-0 Cavaliers. Nice far back to Blackburn. Out to Morgell. Eagles need to get on the scoreboard. Here's Smith. Smith on the drive. Kicks it over to Nycor. Back to Blackburn. Inside to Lewis. Lewis goes up. Over Williams. No good. And here comes Williams sprinting down the floor. Layup is no good. Eagles got it back. Here comes Morgell. Gets to Nycor. Stolen away by Ortiz. Ortiz down the lane. Tried to dunk it. No good. But foul going to the basket. Ortiz went to slam it. There's a foul. That'll be on Nycor, his first team foul, number 3. Ortiz will shoot 2. He went for the dunk. Nycor gets the foul. And up for the Eagles is number 3, Vernon Singleton, set to check in. And, well, we told you, the Eagles have to stay around early, and right now it is 8-0 with 4:25 to go in the first. First free throw by Ortiz is good. Nycor will come out. Singleton will go in. Ortiz has been mentioned on playing for the McDonald's All-Star Game. That's the most prestigious high school All-Star Game, and he may get an invitation. That's how good he is. He puts them both in. 10-0. Coach Case wants to talk about it. Timeout on the floor. 10-0. Calvary Baptist will take a 1-minute timeout. We'll be back. This is Eagle Basketball on the Breeze.
Your life just got way easier with G.J. Curbside. G&J, owned and operated by 3 generations of the Lynn family since 1964, has created a new division to serve the community's retail needs in St. Mary Parish with a curbside grocery and delivery service. Choose from fresh produce, high-end meats, dairy, canned goods, cleaning supplies, and the list grows daily. Visit GJCurbside.com. That's GJCurbside.com.
Harley Holland here with A.J. Doman, Chevrolet Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana. Good credit, bad credit, no credit? Hey, we can help you. We understand. We've lived through this COVID along with you. With your good job and your down payment, we can get you riding in a new vehicle today. Come down and see us at A.J. Doman, Chevrolet Cadillac, and let us show you how easy we can make it for you. A.J. Doman, Chevrolet Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana.
Back to action. Tyler Smith goes all the way to the basket, puts it in, and the Eagles on the board, 10-2. Here's Begley on the outside. Gives it to Ponder. His 3 ball up and in. Ben Ponder hits the 3, 13-2. Now it's three-quarter court zone pressure. Here's the pass down to Singleton. Back out to Smith. Smith will drive. Pull it back. Now he'll get it to Morgell. Over to Singleton. In the corner, Smith. He'll take the 3. Up. No good. Rebound fought for. Ortiz had it. Goes down as he travels with it. Test Action Clinic still testing for COVID-19 in addition to offering COVID-19 vaccinations. Call Test Action Clinic in Morgan City today at 384-2371. Eagles will take it on the inbound. Here's Morgell. Number 11 has checked in. That is Chase Stripling for the Cavaliers. Also, number 24, Trey Kelly. Here's Morgell. Top of the key, Singleton. Over to Blackburn. He drives down the lane. Pulls it up. No good. Foul on the floor. That'll be 24. That'll go against Trey Kelly. Second, third team foul, excuse me, against the Cavaliers. Eagles inbounded under the basket. Out top to Morgell. Sky, free throw line single. He turns, puts up the jumper. Good, soft jumper. Gets the shooter's touch. Vernon Single gets the basket, and it's 13-4. Two-three zone still for the Eagles. Here's Ortiz outside. Long three, way behind the arc. No good. Rebound run down by Calvary Baptist, and that was knocked out of bounds by Blackburn. That shot was probably 6 feet behind the three-point line. And now Williams will come back in. Hondra will get a break. They're really rotating their people. Trying to wear the Eagles down. Here's McDowell on the outside. Looking for a screen. He'll get it over to Williams in the corner to Ortiz. He'll take another three ball. This time missed everything. Way too long. Rebound goes to Smith. Smith. Outside. Eagles will set it up. 2:12 to go here in the first. 13-4, and they say a 5-second call, and I don't even think he was closely guarded. Coach Case doesn't think so either. And now number three checking in, Rondé Hill, and Ortiz will go out. The Cavalier ball, 2:11 to go. Here's Kelly, dumps it inside to Williams. He goes up and scores. Abrez Williams, he has six. And Central Catholic trails now 15-4. That ball almost stolen away. Blackburn gets it back. Back to Smith. Smith on the outside. We're going to drive down the lane. Goes right at Williams, and he'll get foul number two. The job by Smith to take it right at him. And that is Williams' second foul. He'll come out for Ponder. As Smith will shoot two. Tyler Smith. First one is in. He has three in the game. R.J. Bennett, number 13, and Gary Nycor, 21, will come in. D.J. Lewis will sit out, as will Kai Morgell. One more free throw for Smith. That free throw is in, 15-6. 1:30 to go. Ball stolen away by Smith. Down the lane, step through, reverse layup, no good. Puts it back up, no good. Rebound goes to Calvary Baptist. Opportunity right there, missed by the Eagles. Here's McDowell on the outside, on the drive. There's a foul on the floor. That'll be Blackburn, number 11. Four fouls, and Ortiz back in, as is Begley. 1:17 to go. Calvary Baptist will take it underneath their own basket. Here's the inbound Ortiz, free throw line jumper, no good. Good box out, Blackburn with it. Eagles head the other way. Blackburn has it poked behind, but Singleton has it. Back out top to Nycar, three, top of the key, no good. Rebound by Ponder and over the back. I believe that's going to be Blackburn, and it is. That's his second. 15 foul against the Eagles. And now Morgell quickly checks back in for Blackburn. So Blackburn and Lewis on the bench with two fouls. Meanwhile, Williams on the bench for Calvary Baptist with two. Here comes Ortiz into the front court. Good drive, kicks it on the outside. Three ball up and good. And that is Begley hitting the three. That's the second three-pointer of the game for Calvary Baptist. And here's the pressure. Gets it up to Nycor. To Morgell. Morgell down the lane. Floater up, no good. Here comes Cavaliers. Two on one. Begley takes it back out. They say he stepped on the baseline. All will go back to the Eagles. As Begley steps on the baseline. 20 seconds left. Smith will run into the front court. Smith trying to kick it outside, stolen by Ortiz. Ortiz heads the other way. 9 seconds. He goes on the drive. The Ponder layup is in. Ponder gets the layup. And now we have a foul. And that is Kelly. He'll guess foul number 2 on Kelly on the inbound with 0.6 seconds. Not much Eagles can do here. Morgill just get it and fire it. Three-quarter court, no good. And that is the end of the first quarter. The score, Calvary Baptist 20, Central Catholic 6. We'll be back with quarter number 2. This is Eagle Basketball on KBZE.
Located inside Charlie's Pawn Shop in Morgan City is Best Jewelers. They have fine jewelry like diamond tennis bracelets, diamond stud earrings, watches, and many other items. The deals are absolutely incredible. And while you're browsing, let Harold Syracuse check and clean your jewelry. And bring your scrap gold because they pay top dollar. Yes, you'll discover that Charlie's Pawn Shop and Best Jewelers complement each other. Think about it. Best is with fine jewelry and Charlie's with everything imaginable, like guns, guitars, amplifiers, tools, electronics, and the list goes on and on. So what are you waiting for? Are you kidding me? Put your mind at ease. One visit and you'll be hooked. This is truly a delightful shopping experience. It's amazing. You get it all. Friendly, personal service and quality at unbelievable prices from people who care about you. All under one roof. It's Best Jewelers and Charlie's Pawn Shop, Highway 182 East, across from Vita Paint.
Eagles will have the ball to start quarter number 2. Morgan City Mayor Lee Dragnet wishes the best of luck to the Central Catholic Eagles, your champions on and off the court. Foul on the floor. And that goes against Begley, number 15. That's his first. 16 fouls for the next one. Eagles will be shooting free throws the rest of the half. Inbounds to Smith. Also, Taco Bell reminds you they're now available on DoorDash for delivery. Here's Smith outside. He'll drive. Steps through. Layup up. No good as they travel. Too many steps for Smith. Made the layup. No good. And it'll be back to the Cavaliers. 20-6. Coach Case was really concerned about a fast start by the Cavaliers, and it took the Eagles a while to get their feet under them, and then the Cavaliers showed why they're one of the best teams in Division IV. And there's a reach-in by Smith. He gets the call for the foul. That's his first. Team foul number 6 for the Eagles. So both teams now will be shooting free throws the rest of the half. Begley inbound. Number 11, Chase Triplin back in the ball game. Here's McDowell off to Begley. Over to Ortiz. Double screen. Shot up. No good. Ponder with the rebound. Left-handed. Goes up. No good. Ponder got it back. Put it up and in. Ponder. Step on battling. He puts it back in. 22-6. Lewis has it poked away. Ortiz loses the handle on the floor as Nycorn as he travels with it. DJ got caught bringing the ball up. They poked it away from him, and R.J. Bennett will check in. Here's the inbound to Ortiz. Ortiz. Over to McDowell. Begley, top of the key. Back out to McDowell. Eagles now man-to-man. Begley down the lane. Throws it up. No good. Rebound goes to Morgell. The rebound by Morgell. He gets it over to Blackburn. Blackburn takes it up. Eagles need to find some offense. Before, it's been mostly Tyler Smith. Smith double team. Now he'll come out of it. Now he'll drive down the lane. Layup nicely done by Smith. He has 6. He's bringing it right to the heart of that Cavalier defense. Vernon Singleton will check in for the Eagles' next dead ball. 6 minutes to go in the first half. 22-8. Calvary Baptist on top of Central Catholic. state quarterfinals in Division IV. Ortiz looking for the screen. Goes back, takes the jumper, in. Well, it's only a matter of time before he got it going, and boy, he put that one in. Nice three-pointer, 25-8. Here's R.J. Bennett back to Blackburn down the lane. Layup, no good. Tip back, Lewis in. T.J. Lewis gets his first back, a basket on a putback, 25-10. Begley, wide open, three, no good. Rebound, R.J. Bennett, good rebound. R.J. Blackburn down the lane, steps through, comes back in. Two in a row for the Eagles. Blackburn's first basket, 25-12. Here's Ortiz. Three-pointer, way outside, no good. Rebound, Morgell. Here comes the Eagles. Smith down the lane. Puts it up, no good. He's fouled. That'll go against number five. That is Martin McDowell, his first, and Smith will go to the line for a one-and-one. It looks like, I don't know why they're not getting, oh, they said it was a two-shot foul, I'm sorry. Two-shot. First one rolls around and down. Williams back in for Stripling for the Cavaliers, and meanwhile, Blackman will take a break. Singleton goes in, and it's 25-13. Looks like at the end of the first quarter, Cavaliers were running high, but the Eagles now cutting into that lead. Another make by Smith, and he has eight, and it's 25-14. The big key is what big man gets the next foul, Williams or Lewis. Williams to the basket. Lewis blocked from the back. DJ gets a big block, and there's Smith with it. Ortiz tried for the steal, didn't get it. Smith in the corner. Singleton spots up for three. No good. Rebound tipped around. Back in the hands of Smith. Smith will take the three. No good. Rebound goes to Williams. Williams comes out with it. Up ahead to Begley. And he says timeout. Cavaliers called it. Timeout on the floor. 4:23 to go in the half. 25-14. Calvary Baptist. We'll take a 1 minute timeout. This is Eagle Basketball on the Breeze.
Is knee pain keeping you from living your best life? Get back into the swing of things with a robotic-assisted knee replacement from Thibodeau Regional Health System. Robotic-assisted knee replacement means greater precision and a joint replacement that's customized to your anatomy. And this could mean less pain and a quicker recovery. Most importantly, it can mean improving your quality of life. Learn more at Thibodeau.com.
It's time for you to save like never before at A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Are you ready for a great deal? A money-saving party! We got new and used cars, trucks, and vans. We'll get you quick started. Yeah, our service and selection are out of sight. Come deal with us, we're gonna treat you right.
A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep. On the corner of Highway 90 and 182 at the foot of the bridge in Berwick.
25-14, this scoring update brought to you by Morgan City Councilman Louis Camparella and the St. Mary Parish officials, Parish President David Hannegriff, Assessor Jared Lohman, and Sheriff Clay Smith. Also, State Senator Brett Allan wishes the best of luck to the Central Cali Eagles tonight, along with the crew at Hallamar and Conrad Shipyard. There's a foul underneath the basket, and that's going to go against DJ Lewis. We talked about the next one to get the foul. If Lewis, that is three. He will have to sit down for the rest of the half, 4 minutes exactly left. And it's Nicar will come in, and Williams will go to the line. So Lewis with three fouls. This big for Central Catholic. Lewis's first one is a 1-1. No good. Ponder was there, into the hands, and stolen away by Smith. Quick hands by Tyler Smith. He comes heading the other way. Down the lane, step through, blocked by Williams. Smith split the defense, but Williams was waiting back there, and he got the block. I ain't going to stop Tyler. He's going to keep on bringing it to him, and hopefully he can get his third foul here shortly. Inbound goes to Singleton. He'll get it back out to Smith. He'll drive. Looking right at Williams. He goes, stops, pull up, no good. And R.J. Bennett climbs the back of Ponder. Bennett will get the foul, and we'll walk back down. Eagles. I'd get in good position. Ponder. He's about 6'5", and I tell you what, he can really get position on that inside. Ponder. He has 9 in the game. He's the leading scorer for Calvary Baptist. Make it 10 as he hit that one. And the lead pushes back to 12 with 3:42 to go in the half. Franklin's already advanced to the state semifinals as he misses the second one. Rebound to Blackman. We'll talk about that at halftime, who they might match up with. But either way, it'll be the Burton Coliseum next week, and you can catch all the action on KBZE. Vernon Singleton outside, cross court, stolen away by Ortiz. Ortiz down the lane, layup is in. Ortiz gets the layup, bad pass by the Eagles, and they make them pay, 28-14. Here's Singleton, back out to Smith. Calvary Baptist now sinks back into a 2-3 zone. Here's Blackburn. Gets the screen, jump shot, free throw line, no good. Bennett goes up, gets the rebound, but he got it back. Layup blocked away from Blackburn by Ponder. And Ortiz has it. 2:45 to go. Dump down inside to Williams. He just was barreling in. Just too strong inside for the youngster, R.J. Bennett. Williams puts it in, 30-14. Eagles had it to 11. Calvary Baptist now starting to extend that lead. Here's Singleton. Over to Blackburn. Blackburn drives, throws it up wildly, and Singleton, Williams gets the rebound, and they foul him in the backcourt, trying to get the steal. And now Williams will shoot 2. And that's Blackburn, and he has 3. Top of the broadcast, we told you, the Eagles can ill afford to get in foul trouble, and boy, that's exactly what they have done. .217 to go, and Williams will shoot 2. He is 2-4 from the line. Blackburn sits down. Williams' first one up, no good. Rebound by Bennett. Here comes Smith. He has been the offense so far for the Eagles. He's got 8 of the 14 points. Here's Morgell outside. Singleton, free throw line. He turns, he sees Smith, and he backs out of there. Got to move the ball, got to try to get it inside and make Smith play you. Three-pointer by Singleton, no good. Ponder is there to outbattle 2 Eagles on a rebound. He heads the other way. Down the lane, Ponder. Layup is in. He took it straight to the basket. No one picked him up. And it's 32-14. Here's Smith between the legs over to Morgell. Free throw line, Bennett kicks it out to Smith. Three-pointer, left side, good. Tyler Smith with a three-pointer, 32-17. Here's Begley. Out to Ponder, top of the key. Dumped down to Williams, knocked out of the hands by Smith, by Williams. Excuse me, by Tyler Smith. Good hands by the Eagle point guard. Morgell, long three, no good. Williams is there to corral the rebound. Up ahead. Quickly layup, no good. Ortiz put back, no good. Ortiz another chance, no good, and the Eagles got it back. Hill missed the layup, and then Ortiz missed 2 putbacks. And now 35 seconds left. And Coach K said, let's play for 1 if we can, unless we get a good one. Here's Nycar back out. Singleton back to Smith. Over to Singleton, dumped it to Bennett. Morgell, corner to Nycar, 3 on the way. Good! Gary Nycar, good ball move at that time by the Eagles. And with 12 seconds left, it's 32-20. Let's see, Ortiz walking it up with 8 seconds. Working on Smith. He'll drive by and down the lane, and he runs into Nycourt. Charge! Charging foul on number two. And there's Ortiz's second foul. Good job by Nycourt to step in and take the charge. So he makes the three, then steps in and takes the charge. And now, post possession, they said he got rid of it. And now Nycourt will shoot a one and one with 0.3. No, I'm sorry, Central Catholic will inbound with 0.3 seconds. So you got to catch and shoot. And I mean, that's going to be a tall order from full court. I mean, they'll just get it in and they'll let the time run out. But boy, a late run by Central Catholic, down 12 here as we go to the half. We'll take a five-minute timeout when we come back. We'll talk about the first half here, tell you about the Franklin win, and hopefully get two St. Mary teams into the state semifinals. 32-20, Calvary on top. You're listening to Central Catholic Basketball right here on KBZE.
It's time for you to save like never before at A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Are you ready? We're gonna treat you right.
A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep on the corner of Highway 90 and 182 at the foot of the bridge in Berwick.
Now with Taco Bell's app, you can build a box filled with your favorites. Personally, I go with the Chalupa.
What? You mean Crunchwrap Supreme, plus that beefy five-layer burrito
and... Perhaps you meant bean burrito, grilled with chips and nacho cheese sauce.
Nah, you got a vibe with cinnamon twists and a Baja Blast.
Eat like you with Taco Bell's Build Your Own Cravings box, exclusively online or with the Taco Bell app. Must make selections from predetermined menu items and limited participating U.S. locations for a limited time online or in the Taco Bell app only. Contact store for participation, which varies. Drinks exclude freezes.
Your cravings for Taco Bell's nacho fries can haunt you anywhere, at any time, and there's only one way to escape. Run to a participating Taco Bell location near you, because nacho fries are back for a limited time. DoorDash delivery available.
Harley Holland here with A.J. Doman, Chevrolet Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana. Good credit, bad credit, no credit. Hey, we can help you. We understand. We've lived through this COVID along with you. With your good job and your down payment, we can get you riding in a new vehicle today. Come down and see us at A.J. Doman Chevrolet Cadillac and let us show you how easy we can make it for you. A.J. Doman Chevrolet Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana.
Located inside Charlie's Pawn Shop in Morgan City is Best Jewelers. They have fine jewelry like diamond tennis bracelets, diamond stud earrings, watches, and many other items. The deals are absolutely incredible. And while you're browsing, let Harold Syracuse check and clean your jewelry. And bring your scrap gold because they pay top dollar. Yes, you'll discover that Charlie's Pawn Shop and Best Jewelers complement each other. Think about it. Best is with fine jewelry and Charlie's with everything imaginable, like guns, guitars, amplifiers, tools, electronics, and the list goes on and on. So what are you waiting for? Are you kidding me? Put your mind at ease. One visit and you'll be hooked. This is truly a delightful shopping experience. It's amazing. You get it all. Friendly, personal service and quality at unbelievable prices from people who care about you. All under one roof. It's Best Jewelers and Charlie's Pawn Shop, Highway 182 East, across from Vita Paint.
Your life just got way easier with G.J. Curbside. G&J, owned and operated by three generations of the Lynn family since 1964, has created a new division to serve the community's retail needs in St. Mary Parish with a curbside grocery and delivery service. Choose from fresh produce, high-end meats, dairy, canned goods, cleaning supplies, and the list grows daily. Visit GJCurbside.com. That's GJCurbside.com.
It's time for you to save like never before at A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Are you ready for a great deal? A money-saving party! We got new and used cars, trucks, and vans. We'll get you quick started. Yeah, our service, our selection are out of sight. Come deal with us, we're gonna treat you right.
A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep on the corner of Highway 90 and 182 at the foot of the bridge in Berwick.
At Thibodaux Regional Cancer Center, we take our role as the leader in cancer care seriously. We have more cancer doctors on staff than any other facility in the region. Using the most advanced technology available today, we're able to fight more types of cancer for the very best outcomes. If you need to battle cancer, you want the experts at Thibodaux Regional Cancer Center on your team. More cancer doctors, better quality care, greater patient satisfaction.
Now with Taco Bell's app, you can build a box filled with your favorites. Personally, I go with the Chalupa.
What? You mean Crunchwrap Supreme, plus that beefy five-layer burrito
and... Perhaps you meant bean burrito, grilled with chips and nacho cheese sauce.
Nah, you got a vibe with cinnamon twists and a Baja Blast.
Eat like you with Taco Bell's Build Your Own Cravings Box, exclusively online or with the Taco Bell app. Must make selections from predetermined menu items and limited participating U.S. locations for a limited time online or in the Taco Bell app only. Contact store for participation, which varies. Drinks exclude freezes.
I don't know about you, but I cannot escape my cravings for Taco Bell's nacho fries. It doesn't matter where I am or what I'm doing or what time of day it is. I see the warm nacho cheese sauce everywhere. I can smell the Mexican spices. Sometimes my cravings even haunt me in my sleep. Luckily, I found out the one way to escape the cravings. Run to Taco Bell, because nacho fries are back. That's right, you're safe, but only for a limited time. So hurry to a participating Taco Bell location near you for the nacho fries box and get your cravings under control. Or they'll control you. DoorDash delivery available.
We're back here in Shreveport, Louisiana, at Calvary Baptist Academy, where we're at halftime. The score, Calvary Baptist 32, Central Catholic 20, in the Division IV state quarterfinals. This update is being brought to you by Morgan City Councilman Louis Tamparella and these St. Mary Parish officials, Parish President David Hanegrip, Assessor Jared Longman, and Sheriff Blaze Smith. Also, Senator Brett Allen wishes the best of luck to the Central Catholic Eagles tonight, along with the crews at Alamore and Conrad Shipyards. 32-20, it looked like for a while there. Calvary Baptist was running high. They had a 20-6 lead at the break of the first quarter and then extended the lead, but Central Catholic came back, got their feet under, and played much better. Only problem is two Central Catholic starters on the bench with three fouls. We'll talk about that. Tyler Smith led the way. He had 11 points in that first half. He had one foul. Vernon Singleton had 2 points. T.J. Lewis, 2 points. He picked up three fouls. The big man in the middle for the Eagles. Gary Nykar had a three-pointer. He had 3 points with one foul. R.J. Bennett picked up a foul. DeMondre Blackburn, he had 2 points, but also three big fouls. Meanwhile, on the other side of things, it was Ben Ponder with 12 points. LaBrez Williams had 8. Daniel Ortiz had 7. Will Begley had 5. Only 4 players scored for Calvary Baptist. Ortiz, Williams, and Trey Kelly off the bench, each with 2 fouls apiece. Let's go back to that Franklin win over Doyle in the state quarterfinals earlier today. Some of you watched it on KBZE.com, 105.9, I should say, on Facebook as it was streamed. Franklin trailed a lot of the game but came battling back, never lost their poise. They got toward the end. Free throws down the stretch. They win it by 5 points. So number 5 knocks off number 4. They advance to the state semifinals. It'll either be Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday over in Lake Charles. Awaiting them is either number 1 Rayville or number 9 Morris Jefferson Community. That is over in New Orleans. Now, listen to this. In game 1 for Morris Jefferson against the Royals Public Charter, they scored 95 points. In game 2 against Rapides, they scored 91. But, hey, better than that. Rayville, number 1 team in the state, they played Welsh in round 1. They scored 110. In round 2, they played Oakdale. They scored 109. So, with either team plays, frankly, it's going to be an up-tempo game, no doubt. Just to give you an idea, Rayville did play Calvary Baptist, beat them by about 18. So, Rayville, very, very good. Meanwhile, Central Catholic with some work to do here in the second half. But again, looked like they really have got their feet under them. Tyler Smith, might have thing and get DJ Lewis going.
I got a key, yeah. Follow me, baby. I got one overseas. Yeah. I got money, 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 I got money,
we're in this massive gym, and evidently our phone service is not the best, as every now and then we drop the call. But my man Sonny Iverson back at the board knows when it's happening, so we'll get it back to you as soon as we can. But we're about to set here for quarter number three. Two quarters left to decide which team will move on to the state semifinals in 4A. Their half of the bracket. The winner of this game will take on the winner of number 7, Opelousas Catholic, and number 2, Riverside Academy. It'll be Begley, Ponder, McDowell, Ortiz, and Williams, starters on the floor for Calvary Baptist. Williams, Singleton, Blackburn, Morgell, and Smith. And it'll be Cavaliers ball to start things here. It'll be McDowell in the backcourt. Eagles will start. Man-to-man. Look for Calvary Baptist to try to go inside quick to Williams and get that 4 foul possibly on Lewis. Here's McDowell dribbling outside. McDowell, and there's a reach-in by Smith. That's a second foul, first team foul. Smith just reached in. And now the Cavaliers will have it underneath their basket, right side. They'll come in to Ponder, back out top to McDowell. 3 ball on the way. McDowell, no good. Williams got it back. Williams blocks him, but let's see. 2 fouls, two shots they call, and let's see who gets the foul. That is Morgell. Morgell was down there as well as Williams, and glad to see Morgell get the foul instead of DJ. And now Williams will shoot 2. First free throw short. One thing about Williams so far tonight, now he is only 2 of 6 from the stripe, 2 of 7, excuse me. One more upcoming. Make it 2 of 8 as he misses that one. And here come the Eagles. Tyler Smith up to the front. Calvary Baptist starts that 2-3 zone. Here's Blackburn. Back out to Morgell. He'll drive down the lane. Puts up the runner. Short, no good. Rebound goes to Calvary Baptist. Quickly up ahead, but stolen by Singleton. Vernon Singleton the other way. Eagles with the numbers. Blackburn down the lane. Step through. Layup is in. Demondrick Blackburn gets it to go, and Eagles cut it to 10 for the first time in a while. Begley comes right back with a 3, and he hits it. So that lead didn't last. 10 points didn't last long. Begley hits the 3. It's 35-22. Morgell left side. In the corner of the Blackburn, looking down to Lewis. Back out to Singleton. Back to Blackburn. Singleton over to Smith. He'll take the 3. Good. Tyler Smith, his second 3-pointer of the game. 35-25. The team's trade 3-point basket. 6:25 to go in the third. Ortiz down the lane. Looked like they had to charge. Williams gets the feed, and he gets it in. Somebody stepped in and took the charge on Ortiz. No call. Williams gets the basket. 37-25. Blackburn left side. Spins down the lane. Blackburn throws it up. No good. Rebound goes to Ponder. Ponder, 3-on-2. Kicks it out to Begley. Same spot, same result. 3 ball. That's 5 3-pointers in the game for Calvary Baptist. 3 by Begley. Timeout, Central Catholic. Coach Case wants to talk about it. We'll take a 1-minute timeout. We'll be back. This is Central Catholic basketball on KBZE. We'll keep it right here. After the timeout, I'll let you know that Morgan City Mayor Lee Dragna wishes the best of luck to the Central Catholic Eagles. You are champions on and off the court. And Taco Bell would like to remind you they are now available on DoorDash for delivery. Also, Rock's Heating and Air. Check out the guys over with Nick Rock at Rock's Heating and Air for all your heating, for cooling. And if you need a Generac generator, check them out. That's Rock's Heating and Air. Central Catholic will have the ball after the timeout, and Begley with 2 threes here in the third quarter. Eagles actually outscored the Cavaliers 14-12 in quarter number two. But so far, 8-5 differential here in quarter number three in favor of Calvary Baptist. Here's Smith. Smith will drive down the lane, try to dump it to Lewis. Knocked away, but Blackburn was able to run it down and save the possession. Inside, he goes to Lewis, and Ponder fouls him from the back. First foul on Ponder. They switched Williams off of T.J. Lewis so he wouldn't get a foul, and Ponder picked it up. Good feed inside by Blackburn. Here's Lewis out to Morgell. Inside to Lewis. He goes around Williams. Up. No good. Got it back. Lay back in. Lewis got his own rebound. Put it back in. 40-27. DJ looked like he got a little more aggressive there with three fouls. And he's letting the hole back. I mean, you don't want to get a foul, but you got to play aggressive on the offensive end. Another three by Begley. That one a tough shot as he was out there and he was contested by Blackburn. Lewis knocked it out of bounds, couldn't control the rebound, and it'll go to Calvary Baptist under the basket. Begley underneath the Ponder, who got position under the basket. Layup is in. Perfect inbound pass. They worked it. And the Eagles got caught with a screen. Layup is in. It's 42-27. 5 minutes to go here in the third. Singleton tried to jump up from the free throw line. Williams blocked it. Ponder up ahead to McDowell. He gets it over to Begley. And to Ponder, he goes up over Lewis. No good. Lewis gets the rebound. Tyler Smith heads the other way. Smith down the lane. Just quick right by everybody. Smith lays it in. 42-29. Smith now with 16 points. Here's Ortiz with a jumper free throw line. No good. Blackburn with the rebound. Blackburn all the way down the lane. Blackburn, reverse layup is in. Timeout. Calvary Baptist as the Eagles have scored five straight. 42-31. We'll take a timeout. This is Central Catholic Basketball on 105.9.
In Berwick, Louisiana. Good credit, bad credit, no credit. Hey, we can help you. We understand. We've lived through this COVID along with you. With your good job and your down payment, we can get you riding in a new vehicle today. Come down and see us at AJ Dome and Chevrolet Cadillac, and let us show you how easy we can make it for you. AJ Dome and Shirley Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana.
Your life just got way easier with G&J Curbside. G&J, owned and operated by three generations of the Lynn family since 1964, has created a new division to serve the community's retail needs in St. Mary Parish with a curbside grocery and delivery service. Choose from fresh produce, high-end meats, dairy, canned goods, cleaning supplies, and the list grows daily. Visit GJCurbside.com. That's GJCurbside.com.
Calvary Baptist with the ball after the timeout. The Eagles cut it to 11 here with 4:10 to go in the third. Ortiz bringing it up against Singleton. Losing that man-to-man. Begley inside to Williams. Goes up against Lewis. No good. Tipped around. Smith comes out with it. Tyler Smith down the lane. Layup. In. Tyler Smith, another basket. And the Eagles now cut it to 9 with 3:50 to go. There's Ortiz down the lane. His reverse, no good. Eagles with it. Up to Morgell. Morgell up to Lewis running. His dunk is no good, but it rolls around and goes down. He didn't get it to dunk, and all of a sudden, the Eagles trail by 7. And timeout. It looks like Calvary Baptist, it's not, they don't call timeout. They had a wet spot on the floor. It looks like Lewis might have got hit in the face. He might be bleeding a little bit. He got a towel on him, and now the trainers have come looking. R.J. Bennett will check in as they try to stop him. Looks like he got hit in the lip, maybe. But, boy, what a comeback by the Eagles. 42-35. Ponder will get a break. As Kelly comes back in, but looked like for a while Calvary Baptist was just had in cruise control, and now Eagles have fought back. The young Eagles. No seniors on the team. Calvary Baptist with 5. The defending Division IV state runner-up. Here's the ball inside to Kelly. Fought for. On the floor, controlled by Ty Morgill. Eagles come out with the loose ball. Here's Blackburn. On the drive, kicks to Singleton in the corner. Three, no good. Williams is there to control the rebound. And Williams will head up the floor. Begley ran out. Nobody was there to get him, and Begley puts it in. The Eagles were trying to battle on the boards, but they didn't see Begley. And he gets loose, and it's a nine-point lead. 2:40 to go in the third. Smith in the corner to Morgell. Back out top to Blackburn. Call it for a screen. Gives to Singleton. Back to Blackburn. Blackburn down the lane. Inside to Bennett. His layup no good. RJ got it back. Gives it to Blackburn. He goes up. Layup no good. Blackburn back up again. No good. Eagles had four chances and could have. And here is Begley again. Ran. He just ran out. Nobody back. Begley with a Snowbird layup and it's 46-35. Singleton down the lane. Free throw line jumper. Up and in. Nice touch by Vernon Singleton. He has four. Eagles back down nine. Under 2 minutes to go here in the third. Here's Ortiz. He goes down the line, but down lane, but he's fouled from the back by Singleton. His first team foul number three here in the second half. So Calvary Baptist will have it. They're still working on DJ Lewis. Got to get that blood stop on his wrist. Inside of his lower lip. Trainer is trying to stop it. And there is a foul before they get the inbound. And Singleton was holding Williams as he was coming around for, looked like maybe that was you. All Vernon can do was grab a hold. He did. And Calvary again will throw it in. Begley over to Ortiz. Three-pointer. No good. Hit the side of the backboard. Here's Smith the other way. And there's a foul. That'll go against Begley, number 15. For Begley, that's foul number two. Only two here in the second half. And Ponder will come back in for the Cavaliers. Williams will go out. And Smith will inbound. Smith over to Blackburn. 46-37, 9-point lead. Blackburn calls for the screen. He gets off to Singleton in the corner. Three ball, no good. Rebound by Ortiz. Ortiz up ahead to Begley. Pops three-pointer, no good this time. Rebound controlled by Smith. Here comes Tyler Smith the other way. Smith down the lane. Layup, no good. The Eagles just missing some easy shots. And the ball out of bounds right off the hand of Calvary Baptist. Ortiz just loses it out of bounds. And now DJ Lewis will get back in. Ball on three, no good. Here's Morgell, pulls it back out. Blackburn on the drive, back to Morgell. His three ball up, rolls around, no good. Lewis tried to slam it back, but it didn't go in. And here comes Ortiz the other way. Ortiz down the lane, and they say on the floor. And that is Singleton. That's three quick ones on Singleton. And that's some subs coming back in. Blackburn will go out. Lewis will go out with the last 54 seconds. And Calvary with the ball. And they have a 9-point lead. Begley will get it back to Ponder in the backcourt. Over to McDowell. McDowell. Kicks it over to Begley. Begley. Back out to Ponder, 41 seconds. And down out to Ortiz. And Calvary Baptist. Trying to get a good shot here, 25 seconds. Ortiz down the lane. And there's a foul on Singleton, and that's going to be four. In about 2 minutes. And that's going to send Ortiz to the line for two with 22 seconds left. And that's going to get Blackburn and Lewis back in. Ortiz. 7 points in the game. First free throw, no good. Calvary Baptist has struggled from the free throw line. That's 8 misses now. 8 of 13. Excuse me, they're only 5 of 13, 8 misses. One more up coming for Ortiz, 22 seconds left. That one in, pushes the lead back to 10. 47-37, full court pressure now by the Cavaliers. Here comes Blackburn, up to Lewis, over to Morgale. They break the press. Out top to Blackburn. Nycar, who has checked back in, has it in the corner. Gets it to Smith, who's driving, and Smith is held. Going to the basket, and that's Begley, number 15, and that's 3 on him. 13 foul. And that'll get Stripling in, and Begley will come out. Eagles with the ball with 6.9 seconds left here in the third. Here's the dump down, but it's stolen away. Ponder was there to get it. Ponder down the lane, cut off nicely by Nycor. Out to Ortiz. He got the shot off. He made it, but it was no good. After the buzzer. 47-37. Calvary Baptist on top as we go to quarter number four. We'll take a 1 minute timeout. Come back. This is Central Catholic Basketball on KBZE.
Hi, my name is Bethany Thibodeau. I'm a nurse practitioner at Test Action Clinic in Morgan City. I'm from Morgan City. I grew up here. I went to school here, and now I'm excited to serve my community here. Since this epidemic and a pandemic has started, we've seen decreases in our number of patients that we're seeing in the clinics. This concerns us, and me especially, because there are many chronic health issues that we are failing to address because patients are fearful of coming out of their homes. I do want you to know that at Test Action Clinic, we are doing telemedicine should you not need to come in for your appointment. And if you need to come in for your appointment, we're taking every precaution to keep our patients safe and our staff safe. To make an appointment, give us a call at 985-384-2371. I'll be glad to see you as a patient.
Now with Taco Bell's app, you can build a box filled with your favorites. Personally, I go with the Chalupa.
What? You mean Crunchwrap Supreme. Plus that beefy five-layer burrito.
And perhaps he meant bean burrito, grilled with chips and nacho cheese sauce.
Nah, you got a vibe with cinnamon twists and a Baja Blast.
Eat like you with Taco Bell's Build Your Own Cravings box. Exclusively online or with the Taco Bell app. Must make selections from predetermined menu items and limited participating U.S. locations for a limited time online or in the Taco Bell app only. Contact store for participation, which varies. Drinks exclude freezers.
I don't know about you, but I cannot escape my cravings for Taco Bell's nacho fries. It doesn't matter where I am or what I'm doing or what time of day it is. I see the warm nacho cheese sauce everywhere. I can smell the Mexican spices. Sometimes my cravings even haunt me in my sleep. Luckily, I found out the one way to escape the cravings. Run to Taco Bell, because nacho fries are back. That's right, you're safe, but only for a limited time. So hurry to a participating Taco Bell location near you for the nacho fries box and get your cravings under control. Or they'll control you. DoorDash delivery available.
Starting the fourth quarter, Ortiz gets a quick reach-in foul. Eagles have the ball, side court. Neither team in the 1-1 yet. Blackburn gets it into Smith. Smith dumps it outside to Morgale. Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound to Ponder. Up ahead, stolen away by the Eagles. Bad pass by Ortiz. Down the lane goes Smith. His layup no good. DJ Lewis tip back is in. Lewis gets the put back. 49-41. Eagles have it down to 8, the closest they've been since the first quarter. Williams down the lane. Throws it up. In and he fouled. Williams went by Lewis and Nycar was there to help. But they're going to get Nycar with the foul. Williams just too big and strong on that inside. And here comes Vernon Singleton back in. That's 2 on Nycor. They'll be in the bonus the rest of the way, but one shot upcoming for LaVres Williams. Lead back to 10. And make it 11 as he hits that one. 52-41. Here's Blackburn. Over to Morgale, back out top to Singleton. Singleton, stolen by Begley. Begley down the lane, knocked out of his hands and out of bounds, and they say off the leg of Begley. Here's a long pass to Williams, back over to Blackman. He'll get into the front court. Blackman down the lane. There's a pushing foul from the back. And that'll go against 24, and that is Trey Kelly. Three on him. Five team fouls now against the Cavaliers. Fouls starting to mount on both sides. Inbound. Quick to Singleton. Three good. Just a quick little inbound. Calvary Baptist wasn't set. It goes. It is 52-48. An 8-point lead, and Calvary Baptist will use the timeout. Excuse me. Central Catholic will use the timeout. We'll take a 1-minute timeout. This is Eagles basketball on 105.9.
Harley Holland here with A.J. Doman, Chevrolet Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana. Good credit, bad credit, no credit. Hey, we can help you. We understand. We've lived through this COVID along with you. With your good job and your down payment, we can get you riding in a new vehicle today. Come down and see us at A.J. Doman, Chevrolet Cadillac, and let us show you how easy we can make it for you. A.J. Doman, Chevrolet Cadillac in Berwick, Louisiana.
It's time for you to save like never before at A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Are you ready for a great deal? A money-saving party! We got new and used cars, trucks, and vans. We'll get you quick started. Yeah, our service and selection are out of sight. Come deal with us, we're gonna treat you right.
A.J. Doman Chrysler Dodge Jeep on the corner of Highway 90 and 182 at the foot of the bridge in Berwick.
52-44. Eagles trail by 8 with 6:15 to go in the ball game. Calvary Baptist with the ball. Here's Begley. Outside. Back out top to Kelly. Over to Ponder. Ortiz, top of the key. He'll drive. Looking for room, but he's fouled going to the basket. And that looks like Blackburn, and that's number 4 on Demondrick. And that sends Ortiz to the line. He is 3 of 4. He has been their best free throw shooter by far. First one, no good. Hey, might have jinxed it. One more left. Eagles down 8. I mean, this has been remarkable. They were down by 14 at the end of the first quarter. It looked like it was going to get worse. There's a whistle, and they say a lane violation by Williams, so no good. The Eagles have it back. Inbound goes to Margell. Back over to Singleton. Man-to-man defense. Singleton will walk into the front court. And there's a hold by Kelly. And that is 4 on Kelly. And now the Eagles will shoot free throws. Excuse me, that's the 16 foul. Next one will be Kelly will go out with the 4 fouls and McDowell back in. Blackburn will throw it in. Getting it back court to Smith. Smith. Right side. Gets a screen from Lewis. Smith down the lane, kicks it outside for a three. Morgell, no good. Morgell got his own rebound. Back to Singleton, three-pointer, no good. Eagles with two good looks and didn't get it to go. That would have cut it to 5. And now, Calvary Baptist has it back. Williams out top to Ponder. They'll swing it around to Begley. Inside to Williams, under the basket. Goes up, lays it in. Lewis didn't want to foul him. Williams puts it in and lead back to 10. Here comes Smith. Smith out top. Singleton again for 3. This one's in. Vernon Singleton, his second 3 of the quarter. 8-7 with 4:50 to go in the ball game. Here's Ortiz. On the drive, down the lane, lays up, no good. Rebound, Eagles. Here comes Blackburn. The other way, Blackburn down the lane. Ponder fouls him, and basket won't go. Blackman went up and under. He couldn't get it to go, but he'll shoot two. And it'll go against Ponder, and that's two on him. And Blackman will shoot a pair. Big free throws down the stretch. The Eagles have only shot six free throws in the game. They have 4-6. Blackman 0-2. 4:35 to go. First free throw is in. Demondrick makes that one, and it's 54-48. This one can cut it to five. And he does. Demondrick hits them both, and it's 54-49. And here comes Ortiz. Out to Begley, down inside to Williams. He's looking to go on the baseline on Williams, and he pushes off, and they got offensive foul. He pushed it off, no doubt about it. He pushed DJ Lewis out the way, and Williams gets the foul. That's his third offensive foul. That's player control, so it won't be free throws. And it'll be Central Catholic ball. A three-pointer could cut it to two. Morgale gets the inbound to Blackburn. Back to Smith. Here comes Smith, bring it up. Smith looks for the screen outside. From Begley. Goes by everybody. Down the lane. Oh, no good. Rebound. DJ Lewis blocked away. Controlled by Cavaliers. Boy, the Eagles again had a pretty good look, and it wouldn't go. Ortiz on the drive. Kicked it way out to Begley. He'll take the three from the corner. No good. Rebound tipped around by Ortiz, and Singleton runs it down. Here's DeLondre Blackburn trying to get around Ponder, and Ponder's called for the foul. Too quick. Blackburn, he'll shoot free throws, and that is three now on Ponder. Ortiz, Ponder, Begley, Kelly, Williams all with three, but meanwhile, Blackburn and Singleton with four. Timeout, Calvary Baptist. They didn't think it'd be this close, and the Eagles right in it. We'll keep it right here. The Test Action Clinic is still tested for COVID-19, in addition to offering COVID-19 vaccinations. Call Test Action Clinic in Morgan City today at 384-2371. Also, Taco Bell would like to remind you they are now available on DoorDash for delivery. And Rock's Heating and Air. Go to Nick Rock and the guys for all your heating and air needs. Also, generators. Get them all Rock's AC and heat today. Tomorrow night on KBZE, it will be Nickel State football. We'll be right down the road in Natchitoches. So a doubleheader for me, Shreveport to Natchitoches. Tomorrow night, the 2-0 Colonels take on the Northwestern Demons. Colonels is really off to a great start here in this spring season. Hopefully they'll keep it going tomorrow. But here, DeLondre Blackburn with a 1-1. With 3:43 to go. Blackburn's first free throw, no good. Off the back iron. Williams collects the rebound. Big miss right there for the Eagles. And McDowell will bring it up. Here's Ortiz. On the outside, down the lane, knocked out of his hands, and he had to get rid of it, and Lewis runs it down. Lewis up to Smith. Smith, outside, three ball. Good! Tyler Smith with a three. It's 54-52 with 3:12 to go. Eagle fans that are here, about eight of them are on their feet. And Calvary Baptist is stunned as Eagles in there. McDowell kicks it out to Ponder. He's looking to drive. He can't. Back out to McDowell. 2:50 to go in the game. Here's Ponder. Over to McDowell. Dumps it inside to Williams. Spins to the lane. Blocked by Lewis. Ponder gets it back. He goes up. No good. Rebound to Blackburn. Here comes Blackburn head the other way. Down the lane. Blackburn. His layup. Up. No good. And they say, a charge on Blackburn. And that'll put Blackburn out the game. Begley. Well, it looked like that Blackburn was already in the air when they snuck under there. And R.J. Bennett will have to come in with 2:31 to go. 54-52. Calvary Baptist on top. They make sure they know it. It's five fouls on Blackburn. He ends with 8 points. Calvary with the ball. Here's Ortiz outside. Ortiz stops, pops the three. Top of the key, no good. Rebound, McDowell. Ortiz stolen by Smith. Smith all the way. Smith, layup is in, and we're tied with 2 minutes to go in the game. Eagles at one time were down 17, and they are back tied. Here's Williams. Down the lane, loses his balance, they say he travels. Williams from the top of the key trying to go to the basket. He travels. Eagle ball with 1:52 to go. Here's Lewis. Back to Singleton. Singleton into the front court. They're trying to keep the ball away from Tyler Smith. Smith trying to go get it. Begley won't have it. Here's Singleton. Top of the key. Looking to throw it. And they say timeout. Coach Case knew Singleton was a little trouble. He called his timeout. Eagles only have one left. They'll keep it right here with 1:37 to go. What a furious comeback in the second half by the Eagles. It was 20-6 at the end of the first quarter, 32-20 at half. The Eagles actually cut it to 12, but they were down by 17 in the second quarter. And since then, they have just battled tooth and nail. And right now, everybody back in Morgan City listening to this like to say hello to Sarah, Haley, and Paige. And Mary, also, Aunt Allison and Brittany, listening back home, pulling the Eagles, trying to get a win tonight here against the number three ranked Calvary Baptist Cavaliers. Ty Morgale will inbound it in the backcourt to Tyler Smith. 23 points in the game for Smith. Tied at 54. 1:25 to go. Zone defense for the Cavaliers. Way in the corner, it goes to Singleton. Demondre Blackman has already fouled out. Singleton to Morgale. They're boxing one and Smith. They don't want him to have the ball. Somebody's going to have to step up and take a shot. Lewis at the top of the key. Back to Morgale. I think Coach Case would love to take the last shot if he could. 1:04 to go. Morgale dribbles and gives it to Smith. Smith to the basket. Goes up over Williams. No good. Rebound. Fought control by Calvary Baptist. He had a lane to the basket, but Smith, the 6'7 center, was right there. Tyler Smith is maybe 5 foot. And there's a foul in the backcourt on Singleton, and that's number five on Singleton. Vernon, two big threes in the fourth quarter. He ends with eight. He's the second Eagle to foul out. And Gary Nykar back in, and it'll be a two-shot foul. It's all fouls on both sides now. Will be two shots. Ortiz back at the line. He missed his last two. 47 seconds left. Ortiz's free throw. No good. They'll have one more. Hadn't been a great shooting night for Ortiz. Nobody on the blocks for Calvary Baptist. Only Eagles down there for the rebound. Should he miss? It's up and it's in. The Calvary by one. 47 seconds left. Smith gets the inbound. They'll pick him up. Man to man. Now they'll double team Smith. Get the ball out of his hands to Morgale. Morgale pulls it out, gives it to Smith. Smith over to Nykar. Nykar pulls up, three-pointer. Good! Gary Nykar, no, they say he was on the line. It's a two. Nykar hits a two. Eagles by one with 23 seconds. And there's a timeout on the floor. Gary Nykar steps up and hits a big two-pointer. And the Eagles by one with 23 seconds left. Timeout. Calvary Baptist. They were running into the front court. Coach got the timeout. And Coach Case got his crew around him. Let's set the reset for you. The possession goes to the Eagles. So on a jump ball, The Eagles will get it back. Both teams will shoot two free throws on any foul. Both teams in the double bonus. Would also like to say hello to Bain and Merle Thomas. Meemaw listening at home. Pulling for the Eagles. Boy, I tell you what. I know people couldn't make the trip up here, but this has been a whale of a game when it looked like the Eagles might have just run out the gym. And, I mean, showed the heart to come back. They up by one. It's not nearly over. Each team with one timeout left. Both teams in the double bonus. 23.9. Calvary Baptist will have the ball out at the side court. Nycar Smith, DJ Lewis, R.J. Bennett, and Ty Morgell on the floor for the Eagles. Begley will inbound. They'll run the inbound play. They'll get it out top to Ortiz. Ortiz looking for the screen. He'll drive down the lane. Goes over Bennett, puts it in with 18 seconds left. Ortiz puts the Cavaliers up by one. Here comes Lewis. Back to Morgell. High into the front court. Timeout Central Catholic with 11 seconds left. Ortiz got the high screen. The Eagles thought he was going to throw it to Williams. He went to the basket, put it in. Cavaliers by one with 11 seconds. The Eagles use their final timeout. They'll have the ball out about half court on the side. Let's see what Coach Case diagrams up here. I know Tyler Smith has had the hot hand, but I'd like to see Smith maybe get the ball or somebody get it drive to the basket, have DJ Lewis down there where he has a chance to get the shot up or get fouled. I don't know if you want to put it all on the outside jumper. If you can force it into DJ, a pump fake, get them off their feet and go right at them, maybe get a foul call and have a chance at the end to win it at the line. We'll see. 11.3. 57-56 Cavaliers on the top. And Eagles have the ball. No timeout, so they have to get the ball in first. You got to beat the five count. And here come the Eagles. Let's see. Looks like Ty Morgell will throw it in. The Eagles will line up in a line at half court. Morgell throws it in backcourt to Smith. Smith gets it. Smith double-teamed. Goes by the first man. Smith trying to drive. 5 seconds. Smith down the baseline. Smith, reverse layup, kicks it out to Nycar. He'll have to throw it up at the buzzer. No good. The Eagles didn't get the shot they wanted. Smith out. Got there. Couldn't have nowhere to go. And Calvary Baptist advances to the state semifinals as they hold on to win it 57-56 as the Eagles fought as hard as you can fight it. Nycar really didn't have a look at the end. He kind of, his pass was low. He got it, bobbled it, couldn't get it up. And Calvary Baptist survives tonight. And they'll go to the state semifinals.